Andy Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today, me say Jamaican, because like I said, you know, at the end of Haitian Heritage Month, nobody's Haitian anymore. I don't fucking know. My patois is really fucking bad, y'all. Like, I'm disgracing all my Jamaican friends right now. Like, I'm so sorry, y'all. Alright, let me stop playing, y'all. Let me stop doing it. Let me take this flag off my head and stop playing games. This is actually my Jamaican flag. I had to do a Jamaican dance in high school before, therefore this is why I have a Jamaican flag. So let's just put that up there. Let's get to the video. I haven't done a story time in a minute. So before we start, this video is not meant to offend anyone. I'm not trying to offend Jamaicans or Jamaican men or anything like that. I'm just telling you guys my experience with Jamaican men and why I would never date another one ever. Excuse me. Whoa, that was really disrespectful, y'all. Let me stop. I'm sorry. This video is not meant to offend anyone. This is strictly my experience that I had. And yeah, like, if you're mad, then you're mad. I don't know what to tell you. It's been brought to my attention that one of the boys that I'm about to speak to right now actually still watches my videos. And I know a lot of you are probably like,
yo, like, he still watches your videos and you're still doing this video, bruh?
Yes, I am. Where's the fucks? Do you see the fucks? I can't seem to find the fucks. Do I care? Bitch, does it look like I care? Don't piss off a YouTuber if you don't want to be a video topic. Like, plain and fucking simple. Everybody who comes across me knows that I have a YouTube channel. Therefore, they know I talk a lot of shit. Therefore, they know that if they piss me off, they gonna make the video list, alright? I'm just saying. Anyhow, this guy still watches my videos. It is what it is. Thanks for the support, sweetness. We're gonna start off with this first story. I first dated a Jamaican in high school. We're gonna name him Michael for the purposes of this video. So Michael lived about a town over from me. And he went to school with a bunch of people that I used to go to school with when I went to Catholic school. So I went to Catholic school, but I left when I had to go to high school and I went to Elizabeth High School. And the town that I was in, a lot of them ended up going to public school, but they went to the school that's in that town. So they went, I'm not gonna say the school, I'm not gonna say no names close to that because y'all will figure out who it is. This boy actually makes music now. And well, he actually always made music, but like, he's more relevant now, a little bit more relevant, and I want to wait to figure out who he is. So yeah, I'm not even gonna say the school he went to. So I had a lot of friends in the school that he went to, so I met him on Facebook. Actually, I never met him in person until like we started dating, but I actually asked a lot of my friends and I was like, yo, who it is, like, what he do, like, making sure that he was no catfish or whatever. We started dating after like maybe a few months, I'm not even sure the timeline there. And long story short, like, I'm gonna keep this real short, he was very freaking mentally abusive. Like, this man, I swear to God, if I would have stayed with him, he probably would have ended up beating me. Like, this man was ridiculously abusive. Like, I'm not even joking. Like, one time we were walking down the street and he pissed me off, like, really badly. And he tried to yell at me, trying to tell me to, like, come to him, like, to come. And I was just like, for what? And he was just screaming at me and he tried to grab me up. Like, he physically tried to grab me. I said, who the fuck you think you're touching? Who do you think you're touching? After that, I was like, no. Like, and it would be a constant thing. Like, he was constantly throwing tantrums, constantly trying to put his hands on me, and I was just like, no, like, I'm not about to be out here. No, this is not gonna be my narrative, okay? What you're not gonna do is put your hands on me, because this ain't that homeschooling biscuit, dog. This ain't that. Like, honestly, he broke up, didn't talk. I still see him from time to time. I still have him on my social media or whatever, so if he sees this video, he sees this video. It is what it is. No face, no trace, no name, no shame. That's all I gotta say. Next story is very recent. So I'm up on Tinder. I like going on Tinder because honestly, I've never made like real love connection on Tinder until this one guy. So everyone else that I've met on Tinder has been strictly business. Like, I've made skits with people from Tinder. I fucking got them to like be cool with me or whatever, but I've never really had like a real like keen interest in someone like legitimately from Tinder until I met this guy. We're gonna call this guy David. So I met him on Tinder. And he was Jamaican. I saw that as soon as I went on the Tinder, and I was just like, oh Lord, I am not a fan of Jamaican guys. Ever since that, I'm telling y'all, ever since the last guy, I haven't been discriminating against Jamaicans. It's not like one of those things it's like, ugh, you're Jamaican, I'm not talking to you. I'm not like in that type of aspect, but it was just like, oh boy, like I had major flashbacks of all the arguments that me and this Jamaican boy had, and I was just scared. I was like, I'm not dealing with this shit again. And I was like, you know what, I'm still gonna give him a chance or whatever. So we went out to the movies, we went to see Get Out, and it was good. Like, we had a very good vibe. Like, this man was very different from my ex, like, for real, for real. Like, it was very interesting. Like, he didn't try anything, he didn't yell at me, he wasn't violent, he wasn't crazy. Well, of course he wouldn't yell at me on the first date, right? But he was very, like, calm and very cool, and like, we had a lot of similar personality characteristics. So we began talking for like a few weeks, a few months, I don't even know, like a month or two. And like, we got super close. I've never in my life gotten that close with someone so quick. Like, we got super close. Actually, I have. Very few times. It's very uncommon though. But me and him got extremely close. Like, he was coming to campus to pick me up. I was hanging out at his house. He was watching Netflix all day. Mind you, I don't even watch Netflix. I'm not a fan of Netflix. I'd rather like just go to sleep. And him clicked like that. We were together almost every weekend. Like, that was bae, like for real, for real. And everything was going perfectly fine. Just a very key informational part of this story. I had asked him if he had a female best friend, okay? Now, if you know me personally, or if you watched my letter to my ex video, which will be carded up here somewhere, I definitely made a video a letter to my ex, which I need to do a story time on it because everybody keeps asking me. Maybe coming soon. Basically, I made a video about, you know, my ex and what happened, and basically the gist of it was that he left me for his best friend. So now every single time I date a guy or I talk to a guy, I always ask, like, do you have a female best friend? Because to be honest with you, like, I do believe men and females can be friends, because I have a lot of guy friends that I've never been attracted to in any way, shape, or form. But a lot of the times, the girls really don't like me. Like, anytime my guy friends get a girlfriend, they don't like me, because, or they don't like my other friends, because, like, especially my squad, they never like us because they assume that we're, like, gonna take their man, or, like, we're interested in taking their man. And that's really not the fucking, like, gist of it. That's not what we're trying to do. But I understand it because it's happened to me, and it happened to me. Yeah, it's happened to me, so like, I understand. So I don't want that type of thing again. Like, I just want to know the fucking dynamic. Like, I want to know, like, what kind of best friend is this? Like, and even though I haven't had any feelings for my guy best friends, I know a lot of my guy best friends have had feelings for me in the past. So I just wanted to know, like, do you have a female best friend? And if you guys have some type of something, you know? So he says, yeah, he has a female best friend, and he's never had feelings for her in that way. He said he's never had feelings for this girl in that way. Not only did he say he didn't have feelings for her, but he said that she had a man and like, he didn't want to interfere, even if that was the case. All this bullshit. He was basically saying, I don't have feelings for her and she got a man anyway. Please keep that, please, please keep that in mind while you watch the rest of this video. So he says he doesn't have feelings for this girl. We're talking, we go about our lives, everything's fine. And then one day he texts me and he's like, oh, I have something to tell you. And I'm like, he hits me up and he's like, yeah, I gotta talk to you. I'm like, oh Lord, it's always the bullshit. I could never have any type of peace, love, and serenity in my life, right? Even though he did the bullshit to me, like, he's actually like a good guy. I'm not even gonna lie. Like, I can recognize good people, even though he did some fucked up shit. Like, he's a good person, I ain't even gonna say. And he even checked out by my friend. Like, I had a friend in high school that's real close friends with him. He checked him out and everything. Like, that's like his best friend. He was like, yeah, like, he's great. He would never betray you, because he knew what I've been through with all these other guys. And he was like, yo, like, he would never betray you like these other guys did. Like, he's a good guy. Like, I give the approval. So I really didn't think I had anything to worry about with this guy. Like, I swear to God, I've never in my life been blindsided that much by somebody before. Like, I've never been this blindsided. I was so blindsided by this guy. I'm so irritated that it happened. He's just like, yeah, my best friend told me that she had feelings for me, and now I don't know what to do. If you don't have feelings for her, then why don't you know what to do? Why is it a problem that, why, what? What's why? I was just like, what? Like, bruh. This shit instantly annoyed me, because one, I do not like being lied to, especially when I ask you. If I ask you a question and you answer the fucking question and you lied to me, I kid you not, you better make sure I don't fucking find out that you lied, if you lied. Because I will go the fuck off. So at this point, I'm just irritated. I'm like, first of all, I'm not gonna be nobody's option. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna stop fucking talking to me and you're gonna figure out what you wanna do. I don't want no parts of this. I don't wanna feel like I'm swaying your options. Like, spend time with her and figure out what you wanna do. Because I'm not gonna be a part of this bullshit that you have going right here. Like, I'm not the one and I'm not the motherfucker too. So he's just like, yeah, but I still wanna be your friend or whatever. And like, I still really like you, and you have the upper hand, and we have so much in common, and we've been talking for just doing all this bullshit. Basically saying I ain't had to worry about anything, but like, really, realistically, like, I'm not stupid. This shit affected me to the core, because honestly, if you know me personally, you would know I don't like anyone like that. It's how I am. I've always been that way. Like, I don't really care about much of anything or much of anyone. I don't usually have feelings like that. I swear to God, like, even when I like someone, I don't really even genuinely like them. Usually I get over it in like a second or two. Like, I'm just not like that. So this guy, like, I actually developed legit feelings for him. And even though like it all happened so quickly, like, it didn't dismiss the fact that I actually did like this guy. I didn't love him or anything, but I actually did like him. And the fact that that happened, it made me have a flashback to what happened between me and my ex. Like, I was really like sad. Like, when I'm telling you, this shit hit me, like, I was sad as hell. Like, I actually cried. And I don't fucking cry. I'm a fucking thug. I really don't cry. Like, I legit cried. Like, I was really sad. Like, that shit made me mad. It made me feel the same way last year when it happened between me and my ex, when he left me for his best friend. So I was like, yo, I really don't have time for this shit. First of all, I could have been dealing with other niggas. Second of all, I could have been getting head from other niggas. Third of all, I could have been getting more free food with other niggas. Like, I just don't like my time being wasted, okay? I really don't. So a week goes by. He chooses the bitch, and I'm just really more mad that, like, first of all, okay, so you choose the girl. I already knew he was gonna choose the girl, but my thing is, why sit there and go through all the trouble to make it seem like you were gonna pick me, but then you picked her? You go out of your way to try to make it seem like I have the upper hand. You're texting me throughout this process. He's still texting me. I'm dry texting him. I don't really even care. Like, yeah, like, all this bullshit, trying to act like everything's okay when it's not. And then he picks the girl and he's just like,
yeah, but like, you know, if I had it any other way, I would be with you.
All this bullshit, I'm just like, this is ridiculous. Like, what? Like, what do you think I am? A fucking dummy? You said you had no feelings for this girl and that she had a man. So she left her man and now she came to you. And now all of a sudden, you go back to her. Oh, well, I've had feelings for her since I was younger. But then, you know, she ain't feel the same way and she had a guy. And I'm just like, you sound fucking stupid right now. You used me to pass the time. And he's like, oh no, I didn't do that. And I'm like, guys, like, please let me know if I'm going crazy. Please let me know if I'm just overreacting here. Please help me understand if I'm fucking losing it right now. You had a best friend. You liked the best friend. The best friend had a man. You couldn't be with the best friend. So now you find me on Tinder. We started talking. Best friend comes back, you go to best friend. What the hell else is there to understand? So he catches himself saying to his friend that, oh, one, it's my fault for catching feelings so quickly, and that basically he didn't know this was gonna happen, and if he had it any other way, he would have chose me. If it was about 5 months later, he would have been with me. But all this bullshit, he has more time spent with her. And you know what? I actually do understand that. But at the same time, don't waste my time. At the same time, don't make it seem like I have the upper hand when I don't. At the same time, don't waste my time. Don't make me an option. And don't make it seem like something is what it's not. Because if you're going to do bullshit like that, you need to recognize the bullshit you do. So he's just basically trying to tell me, yeah, we can still be friends, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, what the fuck I need to be your friend for? You're not about to be out here saying that it's my fault for catching feelings when you reciprocated the same fucking feelings that I did. So that's what you're not gonna do. He ends up texting me and he's just like, oh, like, he's kind of upset that I'm calling him names on social media. And he's talking about how, oh, I just don't understand and I don't listen. I'm just like, what the fuck is there to listen to? Like, I don't understand what I'm listening to. Like, it's very clear cut case. I don't wanna talk and I don't wanna listen. I'm just throwing shade on Facebook. Bitch, you don't like what I post? Delete me? I don't understand why people get so mad when people talk shit about them on social media.
That's your fucking problem. You choose to follow this person. If you don't like what I post, then you can delete me, okay? I don't give a shit. He insists on still supporting me, and he insists on still staying on my socials. So it's okay. I don't have no problem. Stay on my shit. Do what you want. Fess off lit, but I don't give a fuck, all right? Don't be complaining to nobody about what I'm saying, and don't come at me saying that I'm wrong or say trying to make me feel bad for calling you names when you are what the fuck you are, okay? It is what it is. Not saying that you're a terrible person, but what you did was completely ain't shit on every level of ain't shitness that there is. I mean, like, honestly, it is what it is. Like, I'm not gonna be outwardly an asshole to this person. I'm not about to be, you know, just a dickhead to be a dickhead just because this person did whatever they did, even though what they did was completely fucked up. But I'm not about to sit there and let somebody tell me that they didn't mean to do something to me when it was completely intended. Like, I'm not a kid. Like, it's just stupid talking about. And then he was like, oh, well, if I was with you and she would have came back, it wouldn't have happened that way. And I'm like, you sound dumb. No, I would have been right out here looking dumb, like a dumb bitch. You would have left me for her and it would have been a wrap. Like, no, and I would have had to kill somebody's son. Like, really sad. Honestly, it really is sad because I actually had high hopes for this guy. And it's crazy because, like, a lot of my friends who I actually talked about him too, they was really sad for me because it was just like, bro, like, damn, like, you really don't like nobody, you actually like somebody, and look what the fuck they did. I was like, yep. Now, anytime somebody says give chances, anytime somebody says, oh, stop being an asshole, anybody, somebody says, oh, well, you have to like somebody, I'll be like, remember when you said that last time and what happened? Yeah. So, like I said, this man still watches my videos, still likes my social media posts and everything. And it's pretty funny because after this whole situation, he ended up crashing his car. And it's funny because when I first met him, he ended up crashing his car the first time and he just got the car fixed and it crashed again. Some call it voodoo, I call it my ancestors. You disrespect me, my ancestors don't like that shit. My ancestors come after anybody who hurts me. And God counts the tears that every woman sheds at the hands of a man. That's all I gotta say. Karma's a bitch. That's the end of this story time. Like, share, subscribe, do or lat, and I'ma see y'all next time. Let me know what you guys think down in the comment section below. And let me know any type of fuckboy situations that you've been through, because I just can't. Like, share, subscribe, do or lat, and I'ma see y'all next time.